What's good, ladies and gentlemen of YouTube? JDaisy here with the JDaisy Gaming Channel. Kind of doing a little something different this week. We're looking at a movie review. We haven't done one of these in a while. This is Murder on the Orient Express. It is out in theaters now. It's made by 20th Century Fox, was produced by Ridley Scott, and a bunch of other people. You are seeing the trailer now. Later on, it will turn into gameplay from a train-related game. Just wanted to put this video out here. This one kind of flew under my radar, and I never really heard of it. Until some friends of mine said, hey, the new theater, or the theater here got some new seats, you want to go see a movie? So we went and saw it. And it is a fabulous, fabulous movie. Very well, directed, very well shot. All the actors portray their people very, very well. I read the book back in, high school, and kind of forgot about the little twists and stuff. And they do their own little take on it within the movie, and it's portrayed really good. If you enjoy Sherlock Holmes-style movies or Sherlock Holmes books, I would highly, highly recommend this. It is a great murder mystery. The plot is these people are on a train. It's a very exclusive train, so these are kind of more rich, elegant people. A detective, Mr. Poirot, gets on the train because he has a friend that runs the train that will get him across the country, so he's not supposed to be on the train, so he's an independent third party. A murder happens on the train of one Mr. Johnny Depp, and he has to figure out who on this train did it, who could have committed this murder. The train ironically stops due to some snow collapsing, so no one can get on or off the train. Therefore, the murderer is still on the train. So he goes through the investigation process and trying to figure out. It was a fabulous twist at the end. If you don't know it's coming, it is absolutely fabulous. I had kind of forgot about it, like I said, from reading the book. So it was a great, great book, great twist to see it again in theaters. The game you're seeing here is Bounty Train. It's just a game I haven't reviewed. It's train related. I didn't want to keep looping the trailer. It is a great, great movie. It's shot very well. Like I said, the music is done really well. They do some camera tricks that is just really amazing when they're kind of panning on the outside of the train. It's a very practical shot of watching someone walk through the carriage. You actually watch them go from window to window. And a couple of times they would be in one of the carriages in the dining carriage. So everyone's kind of sitting down. The camera would move across a pane of glass, and it would actually show the lines. Like if you've seen a pane of glass that is kind of beveled on the edges where it angles in and then is flat, plateaus, I guess would be the best way to put it. I don't know if they actually did practical effects or if it is practical with a little bit of CG. It has to be, I assume it has to be practical, where you can see that line. It's just beautifully, beautifully shot. In between rooms on the carriage is beautifully well done. Johnny Depp is kind of a heavy hitter name in this movie. All the rest are kind of, I would consider them B-level actors. Even Mr. Defoe, even though he is a wonderful addition and I loved every scene he was in. All the rest are kind of B-level actors. And Johnny Depp, like I said, he is the one that gets murdered. I don't think that's a major spoiler. So he is not in the movie very long. That obviously the murder has to happen fairly early on in the movie. So even though he's kind of the big name actor in this movie, he's not even really in it. And I just kind of wanted to put this out there because I never even heard of it. And, you know, Johnny Depp, how did that fly under my radar? It's kind of a more I wouldn't call it indie by any means, 20th Century Fox and all. But it just was just didn't get a lot of publicity around some of the other major box office hits. So I recommend if you are looking for a movie to go take your parents to or something on Christmas, you know, this is a good thriller, murder mystery type movie, and I would highly recommend it. Even if you have to wait till it's out on Blu-ray or DVD, it would be a very good at-home watch. I don't think watching it on a smaller screen would be taking away from it at all. I'm not going to say it doesn't have a huge replay value. Once you kind of see the twist, it's kind of ruins it. But I do want to go back and watch it again now that I remember what's going on. The main actor that plays Mr. Dufault, I don't know the actor's name, but he did a wonderful job portraying the Sherlock Holmesian man that has all these kind of quirks and little things that make him him, but is a genius in his right mind. So it is a beautifully well put together movie. Just thought I'd let you guys know about a great movie that's out. Maybe you're looking for something to do on Christmas week. You know, you're home with the family. I know that's something my family and a lot of families here in the Midwest like do go to the movies towards Christmas. It's just a nice family activity, and I think this would be a great one to take a family, you know, the parents to. I believe it is PG-13. There's not a whole lot of blood or anything as far as that goes. It doesn't really show the murder per se. But yes, that is just thought I'd let you guys know. We will be back next week with more video game reviews. But as always, we're all in this one together. I'll see you in the next one.